In this video, you'll see how to assess app resilience with AWS Resilience Hub and AWS CodePipeline. With these solutions, you can automate application resiliency assessments from your pipelines that will help catch resiliency weaknesses as soon as a change is deployed. We'll begin by navigating to the AWS CodePipeline console, where a simple pipeline for an existing AWS application has already been created. This pipeline includes a source stage with a code commit provider and a deploy stage that will deploy an AWS CloudFormation template. Whenever we commit changes to our repository, we want to assess if the changes impact the resiliency of our application. To do so, let's first navigate to AWS Resilience Hub. We'll add our application to assess its resiliency. Let's provide our application's name. Next, let's specify how our application is managed. We'll add the CloudFormation stack for our app. By default, a scheduled assessment will run daily. We'll deactivate it since we want to run an assessment each time we commit changes to our repository. Resilience Hub has identified the supported resources from our application. Let's continue. Next, let's create a resiliency policy to define the recovery objectives that Resilience Hub will evaluate. We'll provide a name and choose one of the suggested policies. Let's create the policy. We'll choose the policy we just created and continue. Now let's review the details and publish the application. Our application has been published in AWS Resilience Hub. Next, we'll use AWS step functions to orchestrate AWS SDK calls to trigger an assessment in our pipeline. We'll create a state machine, which is a serverless orchestration workflow. Let's design our workflow visually. First, let's add an action to import the resources for the draft version of our application. We'll update the configuration to use our API parameters. Next, let's add a wait state to wait for the import to complete. Next, let's add an action to describe the resource import status. Again, we'll update the API parameters. Next, let's add conditional logic that will determine what state the workflow should transition to based on the import status. We'll edit rule 1 and add a condition to evaluate whether the import was successful. Let's configure the default rule to return to the previous wait state if the condition for rule 1 is not met. Next, we'll add an action to publish the draft version of the app once the import is successful, so Resilience Hub can run the assessment on it. Once the app version is published, Resilience Hub will start the app assessment. Let's add another wait state. Next, we'll add an action to describe the results of the app assessment. Let's add another choice state to determine how to proceed based on the assessment results. We'll add a success state for when the assessment completes successfully and meets our policies. Let's add the choice rules and conditions. We'll use an OR operator to evaluate whether the assessment is in progress or pending. If either of these conditions are true, The workflow will wait for the assessment to complete. Next, let's add a new choice rule for when the assessment completes successfully. Two conditions must be met, so we'll use the AND operator. The first condition will evaluate whether the assessment completed successfully. The second condition will evaluate if the app meets our policy requirements. We'll configure the state machine to transition to the success state when both conditions are met. Next, let's add a fail state for the choice. We'll also configure the choice we set up earlier to use this fail state. We'll add a new rule in case the import fails and direct the workflow to the fail state. The state machine is ready. Next, let's review the generated code. We'll name our state machine. Under permissions, we'll choose an existing AWS Identity and Access Management, or IAM, role. Let's create the state machine. Now let's return to the Code Pipeline console and edit the pipeline. We'll add a stage to run the resilience assessment. Next, we'll add an action group and name it Run Resilience Assessment. For the action provider, we'll select AWS Step Functions. Next, we'll select the state machine Amazon Resource Name, or ARN, and execution name prefix. We'll use the literal input type and specify the JSON to provide the base for the SDK calls. We'll define it as an output of the CloudFormation template and pass it into the output artifacts portion of the deploy stage. Let's return to Resilience Hub to copy the ARN for the application we added earlier. Let's paste it in the input and continue. Now let's save the pipeline and release the change. The pipeline executed and the resilience assessment completed successfully. Now, let's open the code commit repository for our application. We'll add an updated template YAML file that will weaken the app's resilience. Let's return to the pipeline. The pipeline has been triggered. The pipeline has finished executing and the resilience assessment failed. Let's view the assessment in step functions to get more details. We can see the fail state executed. Let's view the workflow graph to investigate where the failure occurred. The failure happened at choice 1 because the compliance status is policy breached. Now let's return to AWS Resilience Hub to view the most recent resiliency assessment for our application. We'll review the resiliency recommendations. The Compute App component has a policy compliance status of breached because it's an auto-scaling group with only one availability zone. You've just seen how to assess app resilience with AWS Resilience Hub and AWS Code Pipeline. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.